Hello, Internet! Welcome to another tutorial video. This video is about Azure Machine Learning Studio, and I'm going to show you how you can actually build a Hong Kong property price prediction model in under 5 minutes. So let's get going. When you first come into the Azure Machine Learning Studio, on your bottom left, you'll see new, and when you click it, you'll see all these experiments that you can explore, like credit risk or customer churn and all that. But if you want to see other industry-specific solutions, you can go to gallery.cortanaintelligence.com and you'll see a whole bunch of, you know, studio models that you can play with. But I kind of want to show you what you can do from scratch today. So the first thing that you might want to do is to understand how you can input a data file or like a data source. So right now what you see is me uploading a CSV file for a housing data from 1986 to 2016, which is from the OpenGov data view, if you've seen it. And I've kind of cleaned it and I can just upload it right away. But another way to do it is actually getting your data source from, let's say, your SQL servers or Azure Blob Storage or, you know, from a website and all that. It's pretty simple. As you can see, you'll go to HTTPS, choose this one, and you can go ahead to your Azure portal and find your CSV file in your Blob Storage container and take that URL and plug it back to the Azure Machine Learning Studio, and you're all set. Now, since this data set is pretty much clean, you don't really need to edit any of the metadata or do any kind of data transformation, so you can split the data right away. Now, the idea of splitting the data is to have part of your data be the training data set and then the rest of it to be the testing data set. Now, you would use the training data set to, as the name suggests, to train the model. Now, you would train the model with some kind of algorithm like linear regression models, or you would use a classification algorithm, any kind of unsupervised or supervised algorithm. But I'll show you how you can do a very simple linear regression model. And you can choose, without any programming, whether you want to do ordinary squares or gradient descent. And you can actually tweak the learning rate and the number of epochs, or, you know, the regularization weights. So no programming at all. And you would score it, and then you would have the rest of the data set, which is the testing data set, to go against the prediction that you produce from the training data set you give the algorithm to. And then you can actually just run this, but the output that you have from the scored model or the evaluated model, you can actually export it as a CSV, or actually you can export it back to your Blob Storage or your SQL server or your Hadoop or on-premises as well. But let's just try and run this and see what happens. So this is what the original data set looks like. It has the price, the year, the address, and also the grade of each property A, B, C. So A is the most luxurious one, and C being the least luxurious one. And after you run it, you'll see all these green checks. And if you right click and see and visualize the data set for the score model, you'll see this row called scored labels, which is the predicted result of the price. And you'll see the price versus the scored labels are not that off. So the prediction model actually is pretty accurate despite not having programmed anything at all. Now, what's really cool about the Azure Machine Learning Studio is that you can compare different kinds of algorithms against each other in one go. So as you can see, I'm putting in another linear regression model, and as you see, the score labels is way off, so it's not as accurate. And as you evaluate and compare the accuracy and the error of this model, you'll see that the second model is way, way off, and the coefficient of determination is way lower than the first model, which means that the prediction is way off. So this is a really easy way for you to do a prediction model and understand what the data is telling you. So in the next video, I would really love to show you how you can actually test the data and actually use a web app to continuously retrain your model and actually publish it as a web app. So see you guys in the next video.